Once again, Google has blessed us, this time with a whack of new hardware and Google services goodies at Google I.O. 2022. So I'm gonna break down what the top 10 announcements were and what they mean for you. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and enough Google content that I could run my own Google I.O. Today I'm breaking down the best announcements from Google I.O. 2022. There are so many good ones. You ready? Then let's go. We're gonna start with the best hardware announcements from Google I.O. 2022. And first up, the new Google Pixel tablet. The good news, this is Google's first tablet in a long time, since 2018. The bad news, it's not coming until 2023. Yeah. Much like we've come to expect from tablets, the Pixel tablet is meant to be a companion to your Pixel phone. Essentially, Google just gave us a little sneak peek of their new Pixel tablet featuring Google Tensor. But other than that, all they're really saying is that they are, quote, designing it to be the most helpful tablet in the world. So I guess we'll wait and see on this one. All right, up next, let's talk about the Pixel Watch. That's right, the first watch completely built by Google. Pixel Watch will be available this fall along with the new Pixel 7, which I will talk about in a minute. So the Pixel Watch has a circular design made of recycled stainless steel and bands that seamlessly attach. Wear OS has been updated too in order to feature more fluid navigations and smart notifications. And of course, your Google Assistant will be available on Pixel Watch and the all-important Google Maps. You'll be able to get directions on the go, even without your phone. Google Wallet will also work with Pixel Watch, and you'll be able to control and monitor your smart home via the Google app. But Pixel Watch will also have a Fitbit integration for all your health and wellness monitoring needs. Up next in our hardware category, let's chat about all the new Pixel phone models. We've got Pixel 6a, Pixel 7, and Pixel 7 Pro. Ooh, I can't wait. First up, let's talk about Pixel 6a, which will be priced around $449. The 6a features a 6.1-inch display and sleek bezel that we've come to know and love from Pixel 6. It's got a dual rear camera with 12-megapixel main camera and ultra-wide lens. And Google has developed a common hardware system that they've scaled across the Pixel line, giving this A-series phone fast 5G connectivity, improved security, and of course, Pixel 6a is built with Google Tensor. This is huge for a lot of reasons, but the biggest one for me is that Live Translate will be available on Pixel 6a, which is massive. Pixel 6a comes in three colors and will be available for pre-order on July 21st. This is a lot of phone for a little price. Okay, now on to Pixel 7 and Pixel 7 Pro. These babies are gorgeous. The aluminum finish, which is made of recycled aluminum, by the way, has been extended to the entire camera bar. This really shows off Pixel 7 Pro's three camera system. Now, both the 7 and 7 Pro feature the next generation of Google Tensor, but that's really all Google is giving us for now. Just a little tease, these phones will be available this fall. So what goes well with Pixel phones? Pixel Buds Pro, of course. Now these are a completely new offering, expanding on their Pixel Buds. They are the first Pixel Buds with active noise cancellation, and Google says what makes their noise cancellation tech so good is that it's designed around a new processor. Now, of course, they have transparency mode if you don't want noise cancellation on, and they've also got microphones made with noise suppression algorithms so that your voice is gonna remain clear no matter where you are. They've got up to 11 hours of listening time on one charge, plus Pixel Buds Pro come in four colors, and they are going to be available to pre-order on July 21st. So those are some of the best hardware announcements from Google I.O., but now let's move on to some Google services and operating system announcements. First up, Android 13. Android 13 is really focused on not just the phone, but making all your devices work better together. It's built on Google's Material U design language, and in Android 13, app icons can incorporate your color theme, and there's a new media control that's going to change based on the music you're listening to. You can even set different languages per app, which is so major. There are also a lot of security and privacy updates. Google Messages, for example, will now use RCS, which provides end-to-end encryption for a more private messaging experience. Okay, now let's move on to one of my favorite announcements, a new Google Maps update. Google Maps is getting something they call Immersive View, which gives you a better, more detailed look at a location. So Immersive View uses 3D mapping and machine learning to allow you to really explore a city. Google used London as an example during their I/O, and wow, it is amazing. You can actually pan around the sites, check if there's traffic, see how busy something is, and get the weather all in this immersive view. But check this out, you can get a glimpse inside the building too, as if you're actually there walking around inside that location. Holy moly, Tyler Toffoli, can you believe? The coolest part is that this is all done via rendering. It's not like they had a drone inside or somebody physically walking around and mapping out the inside location. I know. Google Maps Immersive View is going to roll out to select cities later this year, and that's really all we're being told right now. I cannot wait. All right, now let's move on to some impressive Google Workspace updates. I feel like we just got a whole bunch and now we're getting even more. Now in Google Docs, users will have a handy summary that is automated. It's their TLDR in real life, meaning too long, didn't read. So Google's using AI and machine learning to automatically pull out the main points of the doc and summarize it for you. So now if you're in a rush to catch up right before the meeting, no worries. Plus, transcription and summarization is coming to Google Meet too. And speaking of Google Meet, those aren't the only updates we can look forward to. Your Google Meets are about to get even better beyond the automated meeting summary because they will use enhanced AI and build off their Project Starline technology to improve video quality even in low light situations. And if you have no idea what I'm talking about when I mention Project Starline, you can watch my Google I/O 2021 recap video where we go over all of that and so much more. Plus, you'll be able to adjust video lighting right from Google Meet itself with studio quality lighting options. Essentially, it'll no longer matter if you're in front of a window or in a dark room. It's just incredible. Google is continuing its progress with Real Tone as well that they did on Pixel, and they're extending that to this technology over on Google Meet. Lastly, let's talk about some crucial updates to Google Translate. I am a huge fan of Google Translate, and this is big. Using advances in machine learning, Google has basically developed a new way to translate, which is really helpful for languages where there isn't enough publicly available bilingual text. Google has developed a monolingual learning method where machine learning can translate a new language without ever actually having seen a translation of it. Can you believe the world we're living in? The future is here, it is now. With that being said, Google is adding 24 new languages to Google Translate. These languages combined are spoken by more than 300 million people. Just remarkable. So of course there are announcements from Google I/O that I didn't include in this video, like improved Google Assistant conversations, Google Wallet, and new AR smart glasses that could very well change the world. So if you want to see all of that and more, I'm linking to the full Google I/O 2022 video in the description below. So what do you think? Do you agree that these are the best announcements from Google I/O 2022? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Google content. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.